إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره. Indeed all praise belong to Allah. We praise Him. We seek His aid. We seek His forgiveness. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا من سيئات أعمالنا. We seek refuge in Allah from the iniquities of our souls and the evil consequences of our actions. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. Remember Allah عز وجل guides, no one can mislead that one. Remember Allah allows to go astray, no one can guide that one. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. I will be testified to the fact that none has a right to be worshipped except Allah, alone, without any partners. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدٍ عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولٌ. And I testify to the fact that Muhammad is the servant and messenger of Allah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ. Oh, you believe. Fear Allah as He ought to be feared. وَلَا تَمُوتُونَ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And die not except as Muslims. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ اتَّقُوا رَبُّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَّفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. O mankind, fear your guardian Lord who has created you. وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا. And created your mate. وَبَثَّ مِنْهُ رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً. And from them made many countless men and women. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. Fear Allah, whom you demand your mutual rights. Indeed, Allah is a watcher over you. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا. Or you believe, fear Allah and say a word straight to the point, a word that is just. يصلح لكم أعمالكم. That He may rectify your affairs. ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. And to give you your sins. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger have already achieved a great success. أَمَّا بَعْدُ فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. Indeed, the best of speech is the Book of Allah. وَخَيْرَ الْحَجِي حَجُّ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَسَلَّمَ. وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد. And every newly invented matter is innovation. And every innovation or every newly invented matter is a bid'ah. And every bid'ah is going astray. And every going astray is in the hellfire. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. يسعدني أن أتكلم معكم هذه اليوم المهم ومفيد. أسأل الله أن يجعله المبارك وأن يستعرض مني ومنكم. I'm pleased to be with you today to speak with you on this most important day and beneficial day. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal that He make it a blessed gathering, and that He accept it from me and from you. Inshallah ta'ala, we want to take a look at a tremendous book that I think all of us know, or we should know. Before then, I ask everyone to forgive me because I'm a little under the weather, So you may be interrupted by some coughing. So may Allah Azza wa Jal accept it from me and accept it from you. Nonetheless, we take a look at a tremendous book that's written by a great imam who died in 329 after the Hijra, with the explanation of a Shaykh Saleh Fawzan, Hafidah Allah Ta'ala. And the book is entitled Sharh Sunnah. Sharh Sunnah. Before we begin, inshallah, I want to give you a brief biography of the Shaykh. Anytime we read a book, we should know something about the author. It's very important. So Shaykh Saleh Fawzan, Hafidah Allah Ta'ala, he says, هذا الكتاب مؤلف البغهاري واسمه الحسن ابن علي ابن خلف البغهاري نسبة إلى بربهار ببهار وهو نوع من الأدوية أدوية. So the Shaykh Saleh Fawzan Hafidah Allah Ta'ala, he said that the book that is offered by Imam Mubahari, his name is Hassan Ibn Ali Ibn Khalf Al-Babahari, related to Bar Bahar, and it is a type of medicine. الَّذِي لَعَلَّهُ كَانَ يَسْتَقِيلُ بِهَا أو يضيعها ونصب إليها. And perhaps because he used to dabble in or used to trade this medicine. So therefore, it's related to him. وهو من كبار الحنابلة. And he was from the major scholars of the Hanbali fiqh. أخذ عمن أخذ عن الإمام أحمد مثل المروازي. And Imam Mubahari, he learned from a student of a student of Imam Ahmed, such as المروازي وغيره من أذن منهم. تبحر في العلم. أخذ العقيدة وأخذ الفقه وأخذ العلم عن كبار الأئمة. And the Shaykh, he goes on to say that Imam Mubahari was well versed in knowledge. And he took the عقيدة and the fiqh. And he took the knowledge from the major imams. The major imams. And this is a brief biography of the Shaykh he gives. But I want to add something additional. Imam Mubahari, rahimahullah ta'ala, he has so much influence that once in his study circle, he has sneezed. And he said, Alhamdulillah. And his students replied to him. And the Sultan was in his palace, and he heard all the voices. And he said, what is that? And his men had informed him that it was the students of Imam Mubahari. And the Sultan, he had said, that man, Al-Babahari, meaning because there were so many students in the study circle, that the Sultan in his palace can hear them responding to him when he sneezes. So the Sultan, he feared his position because of the many students Imam Mubahari had. So Imam Mubahari, he had to go into hiding. And he died while he was in on the run. He died while he was on the run in Hayth because of the fear of the Sultan, of the reputation of Imam Mubarak. Imam al-Bahari was the same one who, when Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari, the founder of the Ash'ari school of thought, when he repented from his deviant belief, he came to Imam al-Bahari and he told Imam al-Bahari that I am now upon the minhaj of Imam Ahmed. Are the brothers with me? Can you, about the salam? Am I clear?
Nah, alhamdulillah.
Am I going too fast?
No, it's Jay, mashallah.
So, Abu Hassan came to Imam Bukhari. Imam Bukhari was a student of Imam Ahmed, like Mubazi and others of him. He said that I've repented to my belief, and I'm upon the way of Imam Ahmed. And Imam al-Bahari said, I don't know what you're talking about. So the point here is that Imam al-Bahari was a great man who was revered, was upon the Sunnah, who had many students, who had to die alone because of his position of clinging to the Sunnah. And the Sultan feared that. And when Abu Hassan came to him, although Abu Hassan had wrote a book, Al-Ibadah, to clarify his previous belief in refuting the people, the Mu'tazila and other than them, which was started by Wasil ibn Attar, who was a student of Hassan al-Basri, the great Tabi'i. And when Hassan al-Basri was teaching the issues of Iman, Wasil ibn Attar, he stood up and said about Iman, منزلَ بين منزلتين, in relation to the believer, meaning that a believer who commits a major sin, he's not a kafir like the Quran believes, and nor is he a fasiq like Ahl al-Sunnah believes, but the Mu'tazila, Wasil ibn Attar, he said, منزلَ بين منزلتين, that he's between two positions. So, the Mu'tazila belief was started by Wasil ibn Attar, who was a student of Hassan al-Basri. And Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari, he began with the Mu'tazila belief because his mother was married to a scholar from them. And then later he left that, and he started his own belief as relates to the attributes of Allah and other than that. But when he repented, he came to Imam al-Bahari and said that I left that belief, although he clearly repented. But it shows in the way of Ahl al-Sunnah that we don't take someone's statement right away. We watch him. If he's a major caller to disbelief and he repents, we watch him and see what he does to make sure he's really upon that belief. And when they seen that Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari, he died upon what he refuted, it was accepted from him. So it was Imam al-Bahari who Abu Hassan came to. This is showing you the status of this Imam. Now, so with that, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to take a look at some beneficial points from this book. And we're going to take a look in the second volume of the explanation of Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, page 249, point number 172. We'll begin with that, inshallah. So, قال المؤلف رحمه الله قال مالك ابن أنس رحمه الله من لزم السنة وسلم منه أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم مات كان مع نبيين وصديقين وشهداء وصالحين وإن كان له تقصير في العمل. So Imam al-Bahari, he mentions in this tremendous book that all of us should have, and all of us should be aware, because this book is a thorn in the side of Ahlul Bid'ah. the people of innovation, and the people of misguidance. And there are people who try to claim that they are upon the dawah. Even they have problems and issues with this book. And I have to point this out. And if it offends anyone, please forgive me, because it's not my intention to offend anyone. But it's my intention to be upon clergy, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَتَرَكَكُمْ عَلَى بَيْضَى لَيْلُحَا كَنَّهَارِهَا لَا يَزِغُ عِنْهَا إِلَى هَذِهِ. That I left you upon clergy. One number she says, Badi. I've left you upon clergy. It's night, it's like day. And no one leaves this clergy except he's destroyed. This book is a thorn in the side of the people of innovation and its gods. There's an individual whose affair became well known. And Sheikh Ubaid, Hafidah Allah, had exposed him. Now, I know the situation before Sheikh Ubaid, because when he was studying there in the Madrasa Saudiya, he would call me 2 to 3 times a week. And when he came home, we had a kind of relationship. And he actually gave a couple of the rules in the masjid I used to be the imam. But when I noticed something from him, about 2 years before Sheikh Ubaid had said what he said, when I noticed something from him, I refused him from teaching in the masjid any longer. And one such thing from him is he made a statement about this book. He said that, and this is before, this is after I removed him from the masjid. He said this statement to me after I removed him from the masjid. But he said that he does not think that the new Muslims should read this book of Imam Babahari. Now, let's take a pause for a second for reflection. Are not the new Muslims in more need to know what is the sunnah, but what is bid'ah, than someone who is firmly grounded in knowledge, mutimakini? The new Muslim is in more need of understanding the sunnah innovation and the methodology of the salaf in relation to it in order to save themselves and their families from the fire. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you believe, save yourselves and your families from fire. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Baqarah, وَمَنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُ بِهِ فَقَدْ اهْتَدَى. If they believe, meaning us, like you believe, meaning the companions, therefore, then they are guided, Allah says in Surah Baqarah. The مَحْفُوم مَخَالَف as the Usuliyin, so people of Surah Fiqh, the scholars say that the opposite is understood. If you believe like the companions believe, then you're a rightly guided. But if you believe other than how they believe, you are misguided. And Allah is pleased with the companions. Radiallahu anhum wa radu an. So to make a statement saying that you don't think that the new Muslims need to read this book, this is very dangerous. And it exposes a person's true methodology. Now, of course, as Sheikh Mukbil, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, that the new Muslims should read the book with explanation, with the teacher, so it can be clarified to them. But to say that a new Muslim does not need to read the book, this is a statement of misguidance, a statement of a person who's trying to keep the people away from clear guidance. So Imam Babahari, he said, and I'm sorry for going off point, but I have to say this in order to clarify about something about this book and how it's a thorn in the side of the people who are misguided. And that person I was mentioning, I'm sorry for not mentioning his name, is Shadeed Muhammad. Shadeed Muhammad, who the people have a lot of shakhsiyah for. But the ulama exposed the situation. made it clear. But nonetheless, Imam Bawahari, he said that those who stick to the Sunnah, they are free from the companions of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, meaning that their tongues are free from cursing them. Their tongues are free from speaking bad about them. Then that person dies. That person will be with the prophets, the truthful, the martyrs, the salihin, the righteous, even if that person had little actions. Even if that person had little actions. So Sheikh Salih Fawzan, Hafizahullah Ta'ala, he says, قال إمام مالك ابن أنس رضي الله عنه من لزم السنة وسلم منه أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم مات كان مع النبيين وصديقين وشهداء وصالحين. من لزم السنة أي سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم علما وعملا واعتقادا ومات على ذلك وسلم منه صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يتعان فيهم أو في أحد منهم صار مع نبيين وصديقين وشهداء وصالحين لأنه مطيع لله ورسوله. قال تعالى ومن يطع الله ورسوله ورسوله فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين وصديقين وشهداء وصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيق. So Sheikh Salih Fawzan, Hafizah Allah Ta'ala, he said that Imam Malik ibn Anas mentioned, as Baba Hari brings, those who cling to the Sunnah and their tongues and their hearts are free from abusing the companions, then that person dies. That person will be with the prophets, the truthful, the martyrs, and the righteous. Sheikh Fawzan said, meaning the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah alayhi wa sallam, meaning in knowledge and action and belief, and they die upon that. Now, I want to make a clarification about the companions, because we have to understand who is the companion. Because the Shia, they say all the companions are kafir except around three. Some of the Shia. The extreme Shia. And there are people who say they're men and we're men, no doubt. But they were different types of men, different breed of men. And also, there are those who cling to our da'wah who say, or used to say, that the companion is one who saw the messenger, who believed in him, and died upon that belief. But this is not correct, because if you say that, then you leave out those who were blind, like Abdullah ibn Maktoum, one of the mu'adhin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the blind man, because he could not see the messenger. So the ulama say that a companion is one. Mu'min yubi, wa mat ala that. Lucky nabi, wa yu'min yubi, wa mat ala that. The one who met the messenger, not saw him, but lucky nabi, wa mu'min yubi, wa mat ala that. The one who met the messenger, who believed in him, and they died upon that belief. Very important to understand that, to add that last part. Those who met him, who believed in him, and died upon that belief. Because there are some people who met the messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who believed in him, but they died upon the belief of Musallamah the Ghani. And Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he had to wage war upon them, because when the messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, died, they no longer wanted to pay the zakat. And even some of the companions in the beginning did not agree with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq in relation to wanting to fight them. because they were the people who believed in the messenger. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he said that in the Quran, Salat and Zakat is mentioned together for 82 times. And those who separate that, separate one from the other, have disbelieved. And Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he waged war, he fought, and the other companions understood that from him, and they fought against him. So therefore, although they met the messenger, and they believed in him, they did not die upon that belief. Because some followed Musallima, the liar. So a companion is one who met the messenger. لَقِينَ لِي وَمُؤْمِنِ لِي وَمَتْ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. Who met the messenger, not just saw him, who met him, who believed in him, and died upon that belief. Also, it's important to know. Also, it's important to know that it's my way not to speak about, because he said those whose tongues are free from the companions. It's also our way that we know the companions, there's some things that took place after the death of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially in the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib, when they want him to avenge the death of Uthman and so on and so forth. It's not my way to talk about some of those things that took place in detail. Not my way to mention these things. And mention some of the things they fell into. Like, that Yahya al-Fajuri, may Allah guide him, who in his book, Kitab al-Jum'ah wa Bid'ah, his book of Jum'ah and his innovations, he pointed out and started to mention certain things about the companions in a way that is not from the way of the Salaf, and nor the way of the ulama. To the point where he spoke about Uthman, saying that Uthman invented and made a bid'ah when it came to the second Adhan in the marketplace. And we know that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِيشْ مِنْكُمْ فَسَيَرَىٰ اِخْتِلَافٍ كَذِيرًا فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي وَسُنَّةُ خُلَفَاءَ رَاشِدِينَ مَحْدِيِّينَ عُدُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِنَوَادِرْ إِلَىٰ آخِرَ حَدِيثٍ. The Messenger said, after me, you see many differences. So stick to my sunnah in the Sunnah of Khulafa Rashidina Mahdiyin and bite upon it with your molar teeth to the end of it. So the Messenger said, here, he said, stick to my sunnah, or do alayha, not alayhima, stick to it, bite to it, meaning their sunnah and his sunnah is one. They're not separate. So Uthman did what he did. It was accepted. So our tongues should be free from them, he mentioned. And Sheikh Fawzan goes on to say that whoever does this and do not abuse the companions, he said, they will be from or be with the prophets, the truthful, the martyrs, and the righteous, because they were obedient to Allah and obedient to his messenger. As Allah said in the Quran, whoever obeys Allah and his messenger, these are the ones who Allah has favored from the prophets and the truthful and the martyrs and the salihin. The fourth surah of the 69th ayah. And as an additional benefit, this particular verse explains the verse in Surah Al-Fatiha. We ask Allah to guide you in the path of those whom he bestowed his favor upon. And amdu alayhim. This verse, the ulama said, explains that verse in Surah Al-Fatiha. 469 explains that verse. Then the Shaykh goes on to say, وَقَوْلُهُ وَسَلِيمَا مِنْهُ أَزْحَابُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَلَمْ يَنْتَقِسُ وَيَتَعَانْ فِيهِمْ وَاللَّهُ جَلَ وَعَلَىٰ قَالَ وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ يعني الصحابة المحاجرين والأنصار وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِلْإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبِقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا أنا إنك روح إبراهيم. So the Sheikh Fawzan goes on to say that those who are free from the companions, meaning their tongues and their hearts, are free from abusing the companions. Am I clear?
Nah.
Am I going too fast?
No.
He said, so here Allah is with justice in the Quran, and those who come after them, meaning from their companions, from the Muhajireen and the Ansar, he said, these are the ones who, based on the Quran, they make dua, and they say to Allah, our Lord, forgive us and those who are brothers who preceded us in Iman. And do not make any enmity or any hatred in our hearts. So here, the Shaykh is pointing out, and so the Hashr, the 10th ayah, 59 and 10, how we are told to make dua. We are told to make dua for those who preceded us in Iman. And did they not precede us in Iman and Ihsan? So we should make dua for them, not abuse them. So the Shaykh goes on to say, ولهذا قال الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى في العقيدة الواسطية ومن أصول أهل السنة والجماعة سلمة قلوبهم ألسنتهم لأصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said that from the fundamentals of Ahl-Sunnah wa Jama'ah, is that their hearts and their tongues are free from the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he mentioned the verse that we mentioned previously, where we're told to make dua for those who precede us Iman. And then Shaykh Fawzan says, هَذِهِ سَلَمَةُ الْقُلُوبِ لِأَسْحَابِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. That's why Mr. Point says, هَذِهِ سَلَمَةُ الْسُنِي وَهَذِهِ سَلَمَةُ الْقُلُوبِ لِأَسْحَابِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. He said that here, this verse shows that our tongues and our hearts are free from the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he goes on to explain the next portion where he says, وَإِنْ كَانَ لَهُ تَقْصِيرٌ فِي الْعَمَلِ. Amen. Even if the person had little actions, meaning that this person, he said, He had short little actions. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ قَالَ تَعَالَى إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مِنْ دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. So he said that Allah forgives what he wants. So even if the person has little actions, but he does not abuse the companions, and he sticks to the sunnah, Shaykh Fawzan said, Hafizah Allah, that Allah forgives what he wants. And he says that Allah says in the Quran, indeed Allah forgives, he said, indeed Allah does not forgive shirk, but Allah forgives other than that from those whom he chooses, whom he wills. And then he goes on to another point. We bring another point here. He says, Qalu Fudhal ibn Iyab, رحمه الله إذا رأيت رجلا من أهل السنة فكأنما أرى رجلا من أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he brings another point. He says, Fudhal ibn Iyab, by the way, used to be a highway robber. He's been a highway robber. And many people feared Fudhal in the past. But then he became one of the great imams, one of the kibar of his time. He said that Excuse me. He says that if you see a man who honors the Sunnah, it's as if you see a man from the days of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sheikh Fawzan explains this and says, لِأَنَّهُ تَابِعُوا لَهُ. Because he is following them. He is following the companions. So this is why, if you see a man upon the Sunnah, it's as if you have seen one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he goes on to say, لِأَنَّ مَنْ تَبِعَهُ صَارَ مِنْهُ. وهو كما قال مالك رحمه الله أولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم فمن اتبعهم صار منهم. So Sheikh Fawzan, رحمه الله تعالى, he says that because that man he's following them, and because those who follow them, he is becomes from them. And it is as Malik said, رحمه الله, those who are with the ones whom Allah is pleased with. So therefore, they are the ones who follow them, so therefore they become from amongst them. And then he goes on to continue. قَالَ إِذَا رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبِدْعِ كَأَنَّمَا أَرَى رَجُلًا مِنْ الْمُنَافِقِينَ. And if you see a man from Ahlul Bid'ah, it is as if you've seen a man from the Munafiqeen. Sheikh Fawzan says, إِذَا رَأَيْتَ رَجُلًا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبِدْعِ وَالْأَهْوَاءِ وَمُخَالِفِينَ لَأَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ كَأَنَّمَا رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا مِنْ الْمُنَافِقِينَ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا يَدْعُونَ الْإِسْلَامِ فِي الظَّاهِرِ بالظاهر وهم كفار في الباطن يريدون المخادعة وأهل الأهواء وأهل البدع فيهم شبه من المنافقين لأنهم يظهرون الإسلام ولكنهم يبتدعون ولا يتبعون السنة. هذه صفة المنافقين. So Sheikh Fawzan, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, Sheikh Fawzan, he said that in relation to the statement of Imam al-Bahari, or Fudhal ibn Iyad, which Imam al-Bahari brings in his book, if you see a man from Ahlul Bid'ah, it is as if you've seen a munafiq, a hypocrite. Sheikh Fawzan said that when you see a man from the people of Bid'ah and desires that differ from Ahl al-Sunnah, it's as if you see the munafiq. The ones in which they call to Islam and they manifest Islam outwardly, but they are kuffar inwardly. And they intend deception. And he said, therefore the people of desires and the people of Bid'ah, they are similar to the people of the Munafiqeen. And Sheikh Usama al-Utaybi, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, a couple of days ago, he sent a WhatsApp in one of the groups. And he mentioned something similar in relation to the Sufiyya and the Hizbiyya. He said that they are like the Munafiqeen. They are similar. Their hearts are similar. The Sheikh Fawzan goes on to say, because they manifest Islam, he said, but they do not follow the Sunnah. They do not follow the Sunnah. And this is a description of the Munafiqeen. And then he goes on and brings another point. And I believe we have about 10 more minutes?
No, yeah, Sheikh, as long as you want.
Not too much longer, so. And he says also another point, Abu Yunus ibn Ubayd, Rahimahullah, كان يدعو اليوم إلى السنة وأجبوا منه المجيب إلى السنة. He said that Yunus ibn Ubay, rahimahullah, he said that it is amazing those who call to the Sunnah today. But what's more amazing is the one who responds to the Sunnah. It is amazing those who call to the Sunnah today. But what's more amazing is the one who responds to the Sunnah. Sheikh Fawzan, Hafidh Allah Ta'ala says, صارت السنة قريبة. قريب من يدعو إليها. أغرب منه من يعمل بها. فلا شك أنه يأتي أزمان تكون السنة قريبة في أهلها. كلما تأخر زمان صارت السنة قريبة وأهل السنة غرباء. لهذا قال صلى الله عليه وسلم بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا كما بدأ فتوبى للغرباء. So Sheikh Fawzan Hafidh Allah Ta'ala says about this statement that Yunus ibn Ubay said that it is amazing those who call to the Sunnah this day, in this day, meaning this day. And what's more amazing are those who adhere or respond to the Sunnah. Sheikh Fawzan said that because the Sunnah has become strange, and those who call to it also. And what's more stranger is the one who acts by it. And then Sheikh Fawzan says, in no doubt, but as shaq, indeed, it has came in the time, meaning our time, where the Sunnah is strange and its people. And in the later time, it will become even, the Sunnah become even stranger. And the people of the Sunnah will be strangers. And he said, for this, the Messenger of Allah, alayhi wa sallam, said, Islam began as something strange. And the return is being strange. So, tuba lil ghuraba. So, and the ulama say this tuba, some say it's a tree in paradise, and some say that it's paradise itself. Then the Sheikh says, they said, the companions, who are the ghuraba? Ya Rasulullah. Qala, alladhina yasluhun idha fasad al-nas. Wa fi riwayatin, يُسْلِحُونَ مَا أَفْتَدَ الناس. So he brings two narrations. One is that the Quraba, the strangers are those who rectify themselves when the people become corrupted. And another narration says they rectify the people when they become corrupted. So we gather between both narrations that the strangers are those who rectify themselves and the people when the people become corrupted. The Sheikh Fawzan goes on to say, هَؤُلَاءِ هُمَ الْغُرَّبَاءُ فِي الْآخِرِ الزَّمَانِ إِذَا فَسَدَ النَّاسِ فَهُمْ يَتَمَسِكُونَ بِالسُنَّةِ وَيَسْبِرُونَ عَلَى مَا نَالَهُ مِنَ الْأَذَى وَيَسْبِرُونَ عَلَى غُرْبَتِي بين الناس لأن الذين يخالفون كثيرون فهم يعيشون في غربة بين الناس. So then the Sheikh goes on to say, so these strangers in the later time, when the people become corrupted, are those who stick to the Sunnah. Are not the people who stick to the Sunnah that they strange? I remember once being invited to a place to give a khutbah. And there were two Arabs who were right in front of me, who were making mockery as soon as I stepped upon the minbar to give the khutbah because my thawb was short. Arabs, Muslim, they started to look look at one another laugh and started to talk to one another, thinking I did not hear what they were saying. Because why? Because the Sunnah became strange in our time. These are people who are born Muslim, Arabs, in the Muslim world, from the Middle of Saudi. But they prefer to be Muslim, to have their pants dragging and to make mockery of the Sunnah. So as the Sheikh mentioned, we are in strange times, where the strangers have become even stranger. So he said that they are the ones who stick to the Sunnah, and they are patient upon the heart. And they are patient upon the strangeness between the people. Those in which who differ are many, and they live between the people in strangeness. I'm gonna read one more point, inshallah, ta'ala, then we're gonna close out, inshallah. Please. Is that Jay?
No, please, inshallah.
No. So the next one we're gonna read, inshallah, ta'ala, is what the Shaykh on page 261, Imam Bukhari, he says. قد مؤلف رحمه الله وقال فذال بن هشام من عظم صاحب بدعة فقد أعان على هدم الإسلام ومن تبسم في وجهه مبتدئا فقد تخف بما أنزل الله عز وجل على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ومن زوج كلمته من مبتدئ فقد قطع رحمها ومن تبع جنازة مبتدئا لم يزال في سخرة من الله حتى يرجي. So then Imam Bukhari in Allah Ta'ala, he said a statement of Fudhal ibn Iyad again. He said, those who exalt the people of innovation, they have aided in the destruction of Islam. Once again, those who exalt the people of Bid'ah, they have aided in the destruction of Islam. And those who smile in the face of an innovator, he has belittled or has been sent down to Allah Azza wa Jal upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And those who marry those under his care to an innovator has indeed cut off the ties from her. And those who follow a janazah of an innovator, they will not cease to be the displeasure of Allah on this person until he returns. Sheikh Fawzan, Hafidhah Allah Ta'ala, he says, for the Ibn Iyad said that whoever exalts the person of bid'ah, he is aided in the destruction of Islam. لِأَنَّ بِدْعَ ضِدُّ الْإِسْلَامِ, because bid'ah is opposite of Islam. فَإِذَا سَجَعَتَ الْمُبْتَدِعَ فَقَدْ أَنْكَ عَلَى هَدِمَ الْإِسْلَامِ لِأَنَّ الْإِسْلَامِ هُوَ سُنَّةِ وَسُنَّةِ الْإِسْلَامِ كَمَا سَبَقَ. He said that, so whoever promotes an innovator, or promotes them, indeed he has aided in the destruction of Islam. And he said, because Islam is the Sunnah, and the Sunnah is Islam, as preceded in the beginning of the book. So the wajibu ala al-insan, an la yu'azima ahlul bid'ah, wa la yamdahu, wa la yusni alayhim. He said, and it's incumbent upon the person that he does not exalt the people of bid'ah. He does not praise them, nor say eulogies upon them. الآن كما تسمعون من مدح الكفار واليهود والنصارى والثناء عليهم وأنهم أصحاب تقدمي ورقي وحضارتي وأننا متخلفون متأخرون إلى الآخرة ما يقولون، هذا من أشد النفاق والعياذ بالله. So the Sheikh goes on to say, unlike those who we hear today who praise from the people praising the Kufar and the Yahud, the Jews, and the Nasara, the Christians, and send eulogies upon them, indeed they say they are the people of progression, people of prosperity, the people of civilizations who are civilized, and we, meaning the Muslims, are backwards, and we are behind to the end of what they say. And the Sheikh said this is the most severe type of nifaq, and we see refuge in Allah. And he says, وَقَوْلَهُ وَمَنْ تَبَسَّمَا فِي وَجْهِ مُبْتَدِيٍ فَقَدِّسْ تَخَفَّ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Whoever smiles in the face of an innovator, indeed he has belittled what Allah sent down to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Sheikh Fawzan says, لِأَنَّ مُبْتَدِيٍ مُخَالِفٌ لما أنزل الله على محمد فإذا تبسم في وجهه منبسطا معه فإنه يكون قد خلف ما جاء في الكتاب والسنة من الهجرهم وبغضهم والابتعاد عنه وعدم رضا عنه لأن ابتسام يدل على رضا والانبساط معه. So the Sheikh goes on to Sheikh Fawzan. He said, indeed, in relation to his statement, whoever smiles in the face of an innovator, he said, because the innovator, he differs from what Allah sent down upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And indeed, smiling in his face and smiling with him, indeed, it differs from the book in the sunnah, from making hijrah upon them and hating them and being far away from them and the non-existence of being pleased with them. Because smiling in their face is indication that you're pleased with them. And he says, whoever woman zawaja kiramatahu karimatahu min muftari'an faqad qata'a rahimaha. Whoever marries someone under his care, whether it be his daughter or his aunt, whoever's under his care, if he marries this woman to an innovator, he has cut the ties for her. Al-wajibu ala man indahu ma'liyatun بنتون أو أختون أو من يتولى عقد نكاحها أن يختار لها الكفء صالح. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أتاكم من ترضون دينه وأمانته فزوجه إن لم يفعلوا تكون فتنة في الأرض فساد كبير. So he goes on to say, because his obligation for the wali, for those under his care, whether it be his daughter or his sister, or whoever it is under his care, for the relation of nikah, that he choose for her somebody that is suitable. Because the Messenger of Allah, what some said, if there comes to you someone you please with their deen, so marry him. If you don't do so, there'd be great corruption in the earth. He says, فَإِذَا لَمْ تَتَحَرَّ لِمَوْلِيَتِكَ المرضية في دينه وأمانته يحصل فساد كبير حيث تتزوجها والد من أهل النفاق أو من أهل البدع فتدل معه وتكون أنت سببا في ذلك. He said that if the wali does not investigate those who he's pleased with in his deen, there will occur great corruption. And then, if he marries her to one of these munafiqeen or people of bid'ah, then she will go astray with him. And you will be the cause of that. وَقَالَ مَنْ تَبَعَ جَنَادَةَ مُبْتَدِيًا لَمْ يَزَلْ فِي صَفَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَتَّى يُرْجِيهِ. And whoever follows the janazah of an innovator, it would not cease being the displeasure of Allah upon him until he returns. إِذَا مَاتُوا لَا تُصَاحِبْ جَنَائِزَهُمْ لِأَنَّهُمْ يَنْزِلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ الْغَضَبُ وَالْعَذَابُ وَيُصِيبُكُمْ مَا أَصَابَهُمْ. He said that. So, when you follow their janazah, therefore, they were descending upon them the anger and the punishment of Allah, which will afflict them. Now, it'll afflict you, it'll afflict you as it afflicts them. It will afflict you as it afflicts them. And his last point. I have to say his last point. وقال فضيل بن إياز again. من جلس مع صاحب بدعة وإذا ورده الأعمى يعني أما في البصيرة وأما القلب. The Sheikh Fawzan said that when Fudail ibn Iyad said, as Imam Baba Hari brings, those who sit with the people of Bid'ah, they would inherit a blindness, meaning the blindness of sight and the blindness of the heart. أَكَلُوا مَعَ يَهُودِي وَنَسَرَانِي وَلَا أَكَلُوا مَعَ مُبْتَدِي. He said, Fudail said, eating with a Jew and a Christian. He said, I'm sorry, eat with a Jew and a Christian, but do not eat with an innovator. Another narration, he said, eating with a Jew and a Christian is more beloved to me than I eat with an innovator. And Shaykh Fawzan said, لِأَنَّ الْيَهُودِي وَنَصَارَنِي مَعْلُوفِ أَنَّهُ صَحِبَ الدِّينِ وَمِلَّةٍ دِينِيَّةٍ مُخَالِفَ لِدِينِيَّةٍ. He said, because the Jew and the Christian, it is known that their deen differs from our deen. وَهُوَ مِنْ أَهْلَ كِتَابِ the أَهْلَ كِتَابِ أما المبتدئ فإنه يدعي الإسلام. أما اليهود أو النصراني فلا يدعي الإسلام. تعرف أنه يهودي أو نصراني، لكن مشكلته في من يدعي الإسلام. وتثق به وتجلس معه فيجرك إلى شره وخطره أشد من خطر العدو ومصريح بالعداوة. We finish. So he said that because you know what you're a Christian, you know they misguided. As for an innovator, he calls to Islam. As for the Jews and the Christians, they're not calling to Islam. So they know they're Jews and Christians. But the problem comes in when the person who calls you to Islam, as you sit with him, and he pulls you into his evil, it is great danger, and it is severely dangerous, more dangerous than the enemy, the clear enemy of Islam. So with that, we say, Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk, wa aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullahi wa lakum. We thank our brothers for inviting me or giving me this opportunity and this mutual benefit. And please forgive me for any mispronunciation, any stuttering, any interruption, whether it be my coughing or my sneezing or whatever it may be. And I hope that Allah Azza wa Jalla accept this from me, accept it from you. And also, once again, please forgive me for... if I went too fast, sometimes, you know, the anticipation and, you know, being into the topic sometimes, you're in yourself. So please forgive me once again. Barakallahu feekum. So with that, I thank my brother Abu Salam for inviting me. So with that, we say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.